folks. If you watched my intro video, then you know that I'm definitely a cat lover. In fact, if Noferblatz would let me, I would be that crazy cat lady that everybody talks about. He keeps me on a short leash. I'm only allowed 2 cats these days. I'm going to be doing a whole series of videos about kitties, but I'm going to start today's with the ones that I grew up with, my kitties from my childhood. And in fact, the very first pet that I have any memory of was a cat. He was an orange tabby named Sammy. If you ever saw, I think it was 9 Lives commercials where there was Morris the cat, wow, that's what Sammy looked like. He was a rambunctious and very sturdy tomcat who took full advantage of those 9 lives that cats supposedly have. He dealt with all kinds of things because he stayed outdoors, so he dealt with all kinds of dangers, and he was hit by cars I think at least 2 times. But well, he was quite the character. I don't have a ton of memories of him, but I know I loved him very much. Then I have the slightest memory of a little white kitten that we had for a short time. Mostly what I remember is the name my sister gave this little kitten, Dandruff. My sister had a quirky way of naming pets whenever she got to name one. There were some other cats, but the next one I recall that really stands out to me was this Siamese who actually kind of adopted us. My dad and I were out in the yard one day when this Siamese kitty comes walking up, but she's walking rather odd. As she got closer, we figured out why. She'd managed to take her right front leg and get it all the way through a flea collar that someone had on her, and the skin was all rubbed raw around it from, you know, it rubbing her plus her probably trying to chew at it to get it off. Well, my dad never went anywhere without his trusty pocket knife, so he whipped that out and with one quick flick cut away the collar, and that was all it took. He became her hero, her savior, and she wouldn't go away. She decided we were her new family. So we started feeding her. She, like all cats in my family at the time, she had to stay outdoors. She was very affectionate, very sweet, and she was very typical Siamese in her vocalizations, hence her name, Loudmouth. If you've ever shared your home with a Siamese cat, you'll understand why. Unfortunately, that kind of led to her demise. We hadn't had her for very long when, we'll say a bad guy. Someone came into our yard at night and decided they were going to break into my mother's car. And Loudmouth went to go say hi, as she liked to do, being the affectionate little kitty that she was. And she did it, of course, in her usual loud voice. Well, I guess the guy thought that would wake somebody in the house, so he killed her and proceeded to break into my mother's car. And you know what he stole? I mean, this was a long time ago, but he did this all for a bunch of cassette tapes. Can you believe that? Kills a cat because he wants to steal some cassette tapes. Ridiculous. Anyway, we had a series of silver tabbies after that. In fact, all of our cats from that point to the rest of my time living at home were all gray tabbies or their offspring, which were various and sundry. but there was, I always get these 2 mixed up, Marty and Mookie. One was the mom, one was a daughter from one of her litters, and I don't remember which one's which, but I'll say that Marty was the mom and Mookie was the young one. And they had lots of litters. They were a lot of fun. After we lost a litter to tomcats outside, tomcats can be a bit vicious. My mom started letting the cats have their kittens in the house. So we got to watch all these litters being born, you know, and there's nothing quite so much fun as watching little kittens playing with each other. They tumble over each other. They're just hilarious to watch. So, and then we would find homes. Once they were old enough, we would find homes for them all. And that's the way it was until, I guess I was a young teen, tween to young teen, I don't remember how old I was, when I think it must have been Marty, no, Mookie, I guess, the daughter of the pair, was our last kitty, and she suffered bumper disease. That was what we referred to it when they got hit by cars. We lived 1 block away from a very busy boulevard, and so bumper disease was a fairly regular occurrence. And you know, every time we lost a cat, it was devastating to us kids. And my mom decided that she didn't want to put us through that anymore. No more cats. We had our shepherd. If you watched last week's video, I mentioned the shepherd I grew up with, but she figured that was one pet's enough. So that's the way it was for a couple of years, I think. When one day at her office, somebody finds this little abandoned kitten, and I mean tiny little kitten, too young to be away from her mom. And my mom knew that there was no way this kitten was going to survive. And my mom was a softie, so she brought it home. My mom, back in these days, wore a London Fog raincoat, big pockets. Well, she put this little kitten in her pocket. And the little kitten in the car, you know, mom's driving home, the little kitten was asleep. Now, again, if you watched last week's video, you know that this is a long drive my mom had to make. It was about an hour-long drive each way. And after a while, the kitten woke up and climbed out of my mom's pocket and started to explore and eventually worked her way up my mom's shoulder, around the back of her neck, and promptly went to sleep right here. So here's my mom driving down the road like this, because the cat's asleep on the back of her neck. She did that for quite a ways. And then, you know, she woke up and started wandering around, and mom could finally, you know, stretch her neck back out. She brought her home. We named her Susie. And she became the first indoor cat. We weren't going to have any more problems with bumper disease. So as soon as Susie was old enough, mom had her spayed and declawed to protect her furniture. And she lived a very, very long life. She loved, absolutely loved anything that crinkled. And my mom carried in her purse at all times two things that crinkled. One were these little hard candies called coffee nips. They're wrapped in cellophane, so they make lots of really good noise. And then she had, I guess, is it Super Bubble? The bubble gum that was wrapped with a loose paper on the end so that it made lots of nice noise. Well, Susie figured out using her nose or her paw to get my mom's purse open. She would, you know, stick her nose or her paw in there and push and push and push, getting the zipper open, you know, until she could get it opened enough that she could reach her paw in, and then with a flick of her paw, flip, you know, whatever, the coffee nip or the bubble gum out of the purse. And then once it landed on the floor, it was bam, 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 bam. She would chase it all over the place and have a royal good time playing with that. That was one of her favorite games that kept everybody in the house laughing. The other thing about Susie is that she thought she was half human and she thought I was half cat. We would play. I'd get like beside my mom's chair on all fours with my butt up in the air wiggling, and she'd get over by the footstool and she'd be up with her butt wiggling, and then we would pounce on each other just like two cats would. And she just thought that was the greatest thing, and that also got everybody laughing. So she was an absolute sweetheart. After my mom passed away, my dad and my younger brother continued to take care of Susie. And then when my dad retired and moved to Florida, Susie got to retire to Florida too. She had a very long and happy life. So that's the last of my kitties from my childhood. And hopefully next week I'll pick up with kitties from my adulthood all the way up to my current kitties. I do want to leave you with one thing. Having been someone who, for the most of her, you know, younger years, had outdoor cats, please don't do that. Please keep your cats indoors. I know they may act like they really want to be out there, and they do enjoy being outside, but it's not safe. There's insect-borne diseases. There's other animals, cats or worse, that can hurt or worse, kill. There's cars that are quite deadly. There's just too many dangers out there, and your cat will be quite happy indoors. Provide them with a few very inexpensive toys. We don't spend a lot of money on our toys, and our cats love it. If you have a screened-in porch, we used to have the last house we lived in had a screened-in porch, and our cats loved it out there. They could smell the outdoors, they could see the outdoors, but they were protected from any dangers. So if you've got something like that, that'll be great for them. If not, then a window perch where they can look outside, especially when the weather's nice, you can have the window open and they can smell everything and they can hear everything. Please keep them indoors. They will live very, very long, happy, healthy lives if you keep your cats inside. That's it for this week. I'll see you next time. Bye.
See ya.